And for decades, her remains were without a name and her family without answers.
Not anymore. The remains of a woman found in 1975 have been identified as Linda Pagano, an Akron teenager who went missing in 1974. News 5 has been investigating this case since last year after a user of the popular site Reddit made a strange discovery. News 5's Jordan Vandenberg talked with that amateur sleuth and Pagano's family.
Well, this really is a tale of two cases, but one of the biggest breaks in both came with a keyboard and decades-old documents. A solemn strip of land in the shadow of a city, a place you come but never leave. They are the nameless and faceless, the unclaimed and forgotten. They are the unknown, but one of them isn't. Not anymore.
As a result of present-day scientific methods and technology, the victim is identified as Linda Pagano.
Linda Pagano, the diminutive 17-year-old, left her stepfather's home in Akron in September of 74. She was not seen again. Then, in February of 75, at the Millstream Run Reservation, a woman's remains were found. The death was ruled a homicide.
No physical evidence was found at the scene. An autopsy revealed that the bones were those of a white female in her late teens or early 20s.
Weeks turned to months, months into years, and years into decades. Michael Pagano's memory of his sister never faded, but his hope in finding resolution did.
I thought this day would never come. I figured I'd die wondering.
And he might have, if not for these people on stage, as well as someone who wasn't. You see, a user of the popular website Reddit was combing through decades-old cemetery records when she came across internment number 82483. The case was not included in the medical examiner's list of unidentified cases. Over the next 2 years, authorities exhumed the woman's remains, sent samples for DNA testing, and confirmed the amateur detective's suspicions. It was Linda Pagano, and her name is Christina Skates.
It is rewarding. I didn't think, I rediscovered her in the records. I never would have imagined that would have led to her actually being identified and me meeting the family.
Skates says the case-breaking discovery was pure accident, but seeing finality and meeting Linda's brother for the first time today made it worthwhile.
How would you say your mother would feel about this if she was alive now?
Wow, I think it'd be hard on my mom. She was pretty much in denial of the whole thing.
It's a place you go but seldom leave. For decades, Linda Pagano was nameless and unclaimed, buried amongst the unknown. Not anymore. She's finally coming home.
I told her through my sister she got a big hug coming from me.
The only person to be named a person of interest in Pagano's disappearance was her stepfather, who died in 1990. Pagano's death was ruled a homicide back then, and the case remains under investigation. Jordan Vandenberg, News 5.